हेलो स्टूडेंट्स,
इज एनीवन इज देयर, कैन यू हियर मी? You can ask me any question regarding this topic if you have any doubts. You can ask me any questions regarding this topic. Anyone is here? Can you hear me? Okay, let's start our new topic. Already we have discussed in yesterday's class the definition of psyllium. I am repeating again. The meaning of the psyllium, actually the meaning of the psyllium is body cavity. Already we have discussed the different types of identifying characteristics through which we can identify the living things. This is called the identifying characters. Already we have discussed the levels of organization, the embryonic layer and the symmetry. Okay, today we are going to discuss about the psyllium, and yesterday's class I am just told all of you the definition of psyllium, but I am repeating again. The meaning of the psyllium is body cavity. Okay, is anyone is there? Can you hear me? Just listen to me very carefully. Okay, this is important. Okay, Gayatri, good afternoon. Can you hear me, Gayatri? Can you hear me? Just write yes or no. Can you hear me? Okay. So already we have discussed the level of organization, second, the body symmetry, and third, the embryonic layer. Okay, so today we are going to discuss about the psyllium. So I think in my previous class, yesterday's class, already I have said all of you the definition of the psyllium, but I am repeating myself again. The psyllium means the body cavity. Okay, the psyllium means, there is a term, the term is the psyllium. And remember one thing, this slide is very important for your exam. So either note it down or take one screenshot of this slide. Okay, so the psyllium means the body cavity. Okay, the good name of our body cavity is called the psyllium. So actually the psyllium is the fluid filled body cavity lined by the cells from the mesoderm. This is called the psyllium. So what does it mean, the fluid filled body cavity? Our body is full of fluid. Our body is made up of the cell tissue and the fluid. Remember one thing, the 50% is the material and the rest of the 50% constitute the liquid element in our body, like the blood, lymph and water. Okay, so this fluid filled body cavity is called the psyllium. But some of the animals has no psyllium, their body is compact. They have no fluid in their body and their body become compact types. So these animals have no psyllium. Actually the higher groups animals have psyllium and the lower groups animals does not have the psyllium. In mammals it forms the peritoneal, pleural and pericardial cavities, but this is not important for your exam note. Just write the definition, just go through this definition and the types of the psyllium. Just go through the definition. The definition is the psyllium means the body cavity. Cavity means the hole. Okay. The cavity means the hole. The cilium means the body cavity or fluid-filled body cavity, which is lined by the cells from the mesoderm layer. Already we have discussed that there are three types of layer or two types of layer present according to the animal's body size. In the lower groups, animals have the two body cell layer, ectoderm and endoderm, and in the higher groups, animals have the three body cell layer, the ectoderm, endoderm and mesoderm. Okay, this cilium, that this fluid filled body cavity is lined or derived from the mesoderm layer, and in mammals actually it forms the peritoneal, pleural and pericardial cavity. These three types of cavities present in the different types of the organ. Okay, pericardial means that it present in the heart, pleural means that it present in the lungs, and peritoneal is present in the kidney area. Okay, so this is not important for your exam. Just go through the definition very well and the types of the and the different types of the cilium. The first is the acylomate. Acylomate means the already I have said it. There is a term where we can find the A or A. It means the absence. Like the asexual, the absence of sexual process, the acylomate means the absence of the cilomate. It means the absence of our body cavity. So this is present in the lower groups animal. Okay. Second is the pseudocilomate animals. Pseudocilomate. Pseudo means the which looks outside from they have, but actually they does not have this body cavity. Okay, and the last is the cilomate animals. And these cilomate animals means they have the body cavity. Okay, so let's start the description, or let's see the description of these three different types of the cilium. And this is important for your exam. I am repeating again, this is important for your exam. Now Gayatri, tell me if you have any doubts. If you have any doubts, you can ask me, because I am repeating again, because this is important for your exam, and just take one screenshot or just note it down the important points, because this is important for your exam's question, 2 to 3 marks question. Okay, just what is the cilium, how many types of cilium present in animal's body, and describe it. Okay. So the first is the acylomates. So before starting the acylomate, we should know about the definition of the acylomates. What is the meaning of the acylomates? Acylomates means the absence of cilomate. A means the pronunciation is the A, not the A. Not the pronunciation is the acylomates. Okay. The pronunciation is the acylomates. So acylomates means the absence of cilomates process, but it means the absence of a body cavity, and it present in the lower groups animals. So what is the main definition of this? The acylomates have no cilomic cavity. Cilomic cavity means the body cavity. Okay, so the acylomates have no cilomic cavity. This is very important point. And second important point, the space around the internal organs is completely filled by the parenchyma tissue. I think this parenchyma term is very familiar to all of you, because already all of you learned all these things in your class 9-10 syllabus. Okay, the parenchyma is one type of tissue. Okay, and there are different types of tissue present in our body: simple tissue, complex tissue. Okay, so the space around the internal organs is completely filled by the parenchyma, and hence there is no body cavity surrounding the internal organs, because there is no vacant space around the internal organs, because these internal organs are completely filled by the parenchyma, the tissue. So there are no space for the cavity, so that's why they have no body cavity. Understood? So I am repeating again that this asks why the acylomates animals present in our world. Okay, the main point of the acylomates animals is, the first is the acylomates animals have no cilomic cavity. You can write instead of the cilomic cavity that you can write the body cavity. Okay, if you forgot the term the cilomic cavity in your exam, you can write the term body cavity. The same meaning is there. Okay, So the ancillomates have no coelomic cavity. Coelomic cavity means the body cavity. Actually, the ancillomate animals have no body cavity. The second point is that the space around the internal organs is completely filled by the parenchyma. Why they have no coelomic cavity? Because the space around the internal organs means our like heart, lungs, kidney, we cannot see from all these organs from the outside. That's why this is called the internal. Internal means which we cannot see from outside, that's called the internal, and external means which we can see from the outside, that's called the external. So the space around the internal organs is completely filled by parenchyma, so there is no vacant space for the cavity. So that's why they have no body cavity, and hence there is no body cavity surrounding the internal organs. And the next point, parenchyma restricts the movement of the internal organs. Okay, only a gut, colenteron and spongiceal exist in these animals, and there is no other cavity. Okay, all we will discuss later about these things, this colenteron and spongiceal. Okay, but remember one thing, you have to write 2 to 3 points. Okay, the main point is the ancillomates have no coelomic cavity. It means the ancillomates have no body cavity. That's why that's called the ancillomate animals. A means the absence. Okay, second point is the why they have no body cavity, because the space around the internal organs. Internal organs means the which organs we cannot see from the outside in their body. These internal organs are completely surrounded by the parenchyma tissue. So that's why they have no body space for the cavity. So that's why they have no body cavity. I mean, that's why this is called the ancillomate animals. Okay. And example, flatworm, colenterates and sponges. Actually, the lower groups animals, the sponges belongs to the porifera, colenterates belongs to the cnidaria. So these lower groups animals belong to the ancillomate animals. So I think I made it clear. Now tell me, up to this point, have you any doubts, anyone? Only Gayatri is present, and the rest of the students, where are the rest of the students? Rijita and other student? Where are the rest of the students? Don't miss this class. Okay, Gayatri, have you any doubts? Okay, Srijita. And where are the rest of the students, Gayatri and Srijita? Don't miss this class. This is important for all of you. Because all exam question will come from this, all this slide, all this topic. Okay, next is the pseudocoelomates. Now tell me, what is the meaning of the pseudo? Pseudo means the just false. Pseudocoelomates means the false. Pseudo means the false. What does it mean, false? There is no true and false, dare true false game. Actually, the pseudo means the false means the just it looks like they have the coelomates, but actually they does not have the coelomates. It looks like from the outside they have the coelomate, they have the body cavity, but they have the actually they does not have the body cavity. This is the basic things of the pseudocoelomates. Gayatri, you have written parenchyma does not collapse on any case. No, does not collapse. This is one type of tissue, Okay. So first point is that as it's neither formed in mesoderm nor it's lined by the mesodermal peritoneum, it's called so. The internal organs lie freely within the pseudocoelom. What does it mean? It means, Gayatri, it's stable. It's stable, Gayatri, it's stable. Okay. So the pseudocoelomates means, just write the definition in this way, that they have no specialized body cavity, but from outside it looks like they have the body cavity. So this is called the pseudocoelomates. Okay, and their internal organs lie freely within the pseudocoelomates. They are not bound by anything. These internal organs are not bound by anything. So this is the basic things of the pseudocoelomates animals. An example, the roundworms and some minor phyla grouped under acetalminthes. Okay, so the just example, just write the example, one example, roundworm. Okay. And remember one thing, in your exam, don't write the wrong information. If you forgot the information, just leave it, but don't write the wrong information. Okay. So the pseudocoelomates means they does not have the body cavity, but from outside it looks like they have body cavity. That's why this is called the pseudocoelomate. Pseudo means the false. That's called the false. And their internal organs lie freely within pseudocoelom and they are not bound by anything. This is the basic things of the pseudocoelomates. Okay. But what is the difference between the acoelomate and pseudocoelomates? The main difference between the acoelomate and pseudocoelomates is both of them does not have the body cavity. But the acoelomate animals, their body internal organs are surrounded by the parenchyma tissue. But in the pseudocoelomates animal, their internal organs lie freely within the pseudocoelom. Okay, just note it down. What I am saying during this live class, just note it down. Okay, because all these things are important for your exam. So the what is the basic difference between the acoelomate and pseudocoelomates? They does not, both of them does not have the body cavity. But the main difference is in the acoelomate animals, their internal organs are surrounded by the parenchyma tissue. But in the pseudocoelomates animal, their internal organs lie freely within the pseudocoelom. They does not have any surrounding membrane. Okay. So this is the basic things of the acoelomate and pseudocoelomates. Okay. Next is the coelomates. Already we have discussed there are three types of coelom: acoelomates, pseudocoelomates and coelomates. So the coelomates and another name of the pseudocoelomates is the eucoelomates. Okay. So the eucoelomates or coelomates means that they have proper body cavity. They have proper body cavity. That's called the coelomates. So what is the basic definition of the coelomates? The basic definition of the coelomates is that they are true coelomates. They are true coelomates in which the coelom is lined both inside the body wall and around the gut by mesoderm. This is the basic things of the coelomates. So the basic things is that they have the true coelomates. It means they have true body cavity and their internal organs are lined by both inside and outside this mesoderm layer. Already we have discuss the there are three types of layer in some animals and there are two types of layer in some animals also, the ectoderm and endoderm in the body wall, and second is the ectoderm, endoderm and mesoderm. So all these internal organs are surrounded by the mesoderm layer, and the coelom is lined by the mesodermal epithelium called as the peritoneum. This is not important for your exam, just write the definition and write one example. In my bio, don't write any stories. Okay, biology is not a story taking making competition. Biology exam is not at all a story making competition. Just write the to the point answer, just write the definition and example. And if you forgot this bookish sentence, if you forgot this bookish knowledge, just write your concept. It will be okay for me. Okay. So just write your concept. Don't write if you forgot the bookish knowledge. Don't write. Okay. Just write your concept. It will be okay for me. Okay. So till now, tell me if you have any doubts. You can ask me. Anyone? Sagayatri, Srijita. Any doubt is there? Can we proceed? Just write yes or no. Okay. So the next is the segmentation. So what is the meaning of the segmentation? Okay, Sujita. What is the meaning of the segmentation? What is the meaning of the segmentation? Anyone can tell me what is the meaning of the segmentation? Okay, Gayatri. Tell me what is the meaning of the segmentation? Segmentation means the division. Segmentation means the division. The biological term is the segmentation. The common term of the segmentation is the division. And remember one thing, this is not important for your exam. Just go through this slide for your better understanding. Okay. So the segmentation, what does it mean, the segmentation? In the annelids, the arthropods and chordates, there is a linear repetition of body parts known as the segmentation. The opposite name, the another name of the segmentation is the metamerism, and each and every repeated unit is called the metamere. Okay, so the segmentation means the division of the body. Segmentation means the division of the body. That's called the segmentation. And metamerism is conspicuous both externally and internally in annelids, and mostly external in the arthropods and mainly internal in man in other chordates. Okay, so this is the basic things of the segmentation. Actually, the main thing of the segmentation is this is the division of the body cavity. This is the division of the body cavity, making segments in of our body. That's called the segmentation, and it's both externally and internally in annelids, and mostly external in the arthropods and mainly internal in man. Just follow this line and remember this line. In case of annelids, the segmentation is both externally and internally. It means we can make any segments of the annelids body externally or internally. We can follow both of these process, okay, externally and internally. But in case of the man or other chordates, we can segment our body cavity mainly in the internally. Okay, so this is the basic things of the segmentation. This is not at all important for your exam. Okay, so this is the chart. Okay, remember one thing, this is not important for your exam, but this is important for your better understanding. Okay, that's why I made this slide. First is the kingdom. I think this is very common for all of you because already you have learned all these things in your class 9. Okay, so I am repeating again. First is the kingdom. The main thing is the kingdom. Kingdom, then phylum, then class, then order, then family, then genus, then species. So this is the basic things. This is called the classification system. If we pick a specimen, suppose we pick a specimen, then we can classify the specimen on the based of this all these things. First we should know about their kingdom, then phylum, then class, then order, then family, then genus, then species. So if we pick one specimen, we should classify this specimen based on these 5 to 6 things. Okay, this is the basic things. Like human, then human, the kingdom of the human is the animals. They belong to the animals group. Okay, phylum means the chordates. Class, mammals. Order, primates. Family, hominids. Genus, homo. And species, homo sapiens. Homo sapiens is the scientific name of us. So this is the basic things through which we can identify or we can classify the one specimen. This is not important for your exam. Okay, just go through this because for your better understanding, and go through this scientific name. Remember the scientific name of us. Our scientific name is the Homo sapiens. Okay, this is very important slide. Notochord. This is very important slide. I am repeating again myself. This is very important slide, and this is also important for your exam. Okay, that's why if you have any doubts, then you can ask me. Okay, and today's last slide is this. So the what is the meaning of the notochord? The basic things of the notochord. The basic term of the notochord, the actual term or the normal term of the notochord is spinal cord. The spinal cord, the notochord means our spinal cord, the backbone. So who has notochord? That's called the chordates. And who does not has notochord? They are called the non-chordates or invertebrates. Okay. So the notochord is a mesodermally part and derived a rod-like structure. Okay. During the embryonic development in some animals. But who does not have notochord? That's called the invertebrates. The animals with notochord are called the chordates, and those animals which do not form this structure are called the non-chordates. This is the basic things, or this is the basic point through by which we can classify any animals. First, we should know these animals either chordates group or non-chordates group. First, we should determine these animals belongs to chordate group or these animals belongs to the non-chordate group. This is the basic things of the classification. Okay. So, the notochord, what is the notochord? The notochord is mesodermally derived a rod-like structure, the spinal cord. Like our spinal cord. This notochord means the spinal cord. So, notochord, the spinal cord, our spinal cord looks like a rod-like structure. Na? So, this is the basic things. The notochord means the mesodermally. Why this is the mesodermally? Because this notochord derived from the mesoderm layer. Already I have said it, we have three types of layer, body layer. One is the ectoderm, the outer layer. One is the endoderm, the innermost layer. And second one is the mesoderm, the middle layer. So this notochord, this bone rod like structure is derived from the mesoderm. So that's why this is notochord is a mesodermally derived a rod like structure from in the dorsal side during the embryonic development in some animals. So this is called the notochord, and animals with notochords are called the chordates. This is the main thing. Remember this term. And those animals which do not have the structure, that's called the non-chordates. And remember one thing, there is also another name of the chordates, that name is the vertebrates. The name of the chordates is the vertebrates. That means who has the vertebral column. Vertebral column means also the spinal cord. So who has vertebral column, that's called the vertebrates. And who does not have the vertebral column, they are called the non-vertebrates, by invertebrates. Okay, vertebrates or invertebrates or chordates or non-chordates. This is just similar term. Okay. So remember this term or other note it down. There is another term of the chordates. The term of is the vertebrates, and there is also the another term of the non-chordates. The term is the invertebrates. Non-chordates means the no chordates. Non-chordates means the no chordates means they does not have the spinal cord. They does not have the caudal area. So that's called the non-chordates. Okay. So now tell me, up to this slide, any doubt is there? You can ask me. Up to this, any doubt is there? Okay, I am repeating again because notochord is very important for all of you. So, notochord means a rod-like structure which actually the notochord means our backbone. Okay, so the notochord is rod-like structure and it's derived from the mesoderm layer. This notochord is a mesodermally. This notochord is a mesodermally. What does it mean? It means the notochord derived from the mesoderm layer and it looks like a rod-like structure and it present and it's formed during the embryonic development. During the embryonic development, that's called the notochord. And based on the notochord presence, we can differentiate the animals group into two types. One is the chordates. Chordates means the animals with notochords are called the chordates, and those animals who does not have the structure and does not have this notochord structure, they are called the non-chordates. Okay. The example of the chordates is the fish to mammals. Fish to mammals group, it means fish, amphibia, reptiles, birds or avies and mammals, and non-chordates to porifera to echinoderm. Gayatri, there is no meaning of echinoderm. Echinoderm is one type of the phylum. Okay, we'll discuss later. Actually, we will discuss this all these things in tomorrow's class. Okay, so this is the basic things of the notochord. Now tell me, if any doubt is there, you can ask me. If you have any doubts, you can ask me, because from tomorrow we will discuss the chordates group and non-chordates group, and this is very important for all of you. That's why I am telling, if you have any doubts, just clear it. Okay, Gayatri. Okay, so don't miss tomorrow and tomorrow onwards class. Don't miss this, because this is very important class. This will be very important class for all of you, because maximum questions coming from this